The best way to see the rise of Maine's drug epidemic is to look at the numbers. The total number of drug deaths per year in Maine from 2002 to 2012 was on average about 160 a year. But in 2013, something changed. 176 drug deaths became 208 the next year, 272 in 2015, 376 in 2016, and 418 in 2017. According to data from the Attorney General's Office in the University of Maine, 87% of those 418 deaths were accidental overdoses, and the vast majority, 85%, were caused by opioids. That steep rise in deaths is primarily due to an increase in fentanyl, a powerful illicit drug, 30 to 50 times more potent than heroin. And many people are buying what they think is heroin. It's actually fentanyl. Heroin and fentanyl are coming to Maine from Mexico, where dealers are growing opium in poppy fields and mixing chemicals from China, making illicit fentanyl. It's then smuggled across the southern border, sometimes in the axles of cars, like in these photos. Maine's location on Interstate 95 makes it easy for drug dealers to just drive up the highway to a target market. We're already a state hooked on drugs. A 2014 CDC report ranked Maine as the number one state per capita for prescriptions for long-lasting opioids. And when those prescriptions disappeared, some Mainers turned to heroin as an alternative. The Department of Health and Human Services estimates 75% of heroin users were either prescribed opiates or tried them first. State leaders say those pills have become a gateway to heroin, which is much cheaper. One dose can be sold in New York City for $5. It can go for $20 in Portland and $40 in Down East Maine. But there is hope. Early numbers from 2018 show the number of deaths may be leveling off, showing prevention and treatment is helping in the fight.